Hi guys, what's up? It's Joel Pitt here, back with another video, and in this video I will be doing a review for a movie that I've just seen recently. It was called Ready Player One. I saw this on the Thursday at the Odeon in the Trafford Centre. But before I talk more about this film, I would like to mention a couple of things. So, on the day, I got this charging lead. Now, it says £7.99, but then when I went to the checkout desk, the person said it only costs £4.99, so I got a little bit cheaper, which is nice, because I needed it for my extra controller, because I've got two now, and I only have one cable, but now I have two, so it's alright. Also, my ticket was supposed to cost £8.35, but instead it costed only £7.87, a little bit cheaper, but, you know, it was pretty alright. Also, I don't know if this is true, but some people have been saying the government might be putting a tax on soft drinks that have added sugar in them. On the 6th of April, which was yesterday, me and my friend Alex, you may know him, he's been in a couple of my videos. We have had our 3-year anniversary on Facebook, but we've nearly been friends for 7 years, since high school, you know. Also, I don't know, you probably noticed, if you've not noticed, McDonald's Monopoly, has already started. It started on the 21st of March and it finishes on the 1st of May. Don't know why I didn't mention that in another video. Also, off topic of that, in college I remember seeing some of the toilets are only used for staff, as I think students used to keep using them, and then they just thought, no, they're only going to be staff, and then everyone just was like, what are you doing and all. Also, ages ago, before, you know, I broke up for Easter term, yeah, for college, I did this FIFA tournament. I might have talked about it in another video, can't remember which one. But, yeah, I didn't do well. I lost, you know. I thought the competition was just too good. But they might be doing another competition, not FIFA, but a different game. So, if, you know, I hope it's not a football related one, because I'll probably lose again. But if it's one that I have, then I'll enter. But then if it isn't, I might as well still enter, give it a try. Also, the Chadwick, just a pub in Urmston, and the pharmacy as well are in Urmston, have closed down. I'm not sure why, but they just have. But anyway, time to get on with this movie review. So at the start of the film, I don't know if you've heard of the tune Van Halen Jump. So, you know, it's a very good tune, but it didn't look appealing, the whole background. It was like a dump site and there was just loads of caravans and all. But you saw loads of people playing VR, you know, virtual reality, and there was some funny moments during that. It was in the year 2045, I think. Also, there was this kid's parent nagging a mum. Something about, there was plenty of jokes in there. Someone, like, rage quit, and they nearly killed themselves. It was just a bit deep, you know, it was a bit deep. And there was this creator called James Halliday, and he created this thing called The Oasis, where different players could, it was like a virtual reality thing. You had your own avatar and you would go into this Oasis and you would win games to get coins, but then if you died you could lose everything and all. But when James died, he did a message to everyone in the world, and he was talking about this Easter egg that you could get control of the Oasis and half a trillion coins, and you had to collect 3 keys in different ways and all. So there was, the main character here was Parzival, and then there was other people like H and another advanced player called Artemis. So the first way to get the key was by doing a race, and so there was different obstacles. So there was barriers, there was the T-Rex, and then at the end there was King Kong. But then after that, like, there was no chance they were going to win because Lazarus... Where did I get Lazarus from? I don't know, but... Parzival stopped Artemis, you know, and... Because she was going to lose in the end and get beaten by King Kong. But then Parzival... I'm still thinking Lazarus... Where have I got Lazarus from? But anyway, Parzival, he went into the memory bank of James Halliday, and then he found out, like, going back in the race was the only key. And then Artemis found out what he was doing. Then he told, she told H, and then H told some of his mates because, well, that's what friends do. And so they got the first key by going backwards in the race, you know. That was it, that was the only way and all. And then, you know, he got, Parzival got all the fame, you know, and then Artemis pretend to be Goro, you know, for off Mortal Kombat and all. And then an alien just popped out of the chest and then scared Parzival. And then Parzival had to dress up as Clark Kent. It looked absolutely ridiculous. There were so many Hi-Fi rejects. Like, there was one that, you know, Artemis didn't do. And then there was another one where, like, the robot wouldn't... It was like, I don't do them and all. And then there was... At one point, there was a lot of touching film from Artemis. Like, it was just not... I didn't like that. Also, his real name is Wade Watts Parzival. Artemis was Samantha something Cook. Not they did mention the middle name, but I couldn't remember that. Also, his place blew up, I think, because maybe he gave away his identity and all. And then, but luckily, he survived. Because his parents died before, and then he ended up living with his auntie or something. Also, they went back to The Shining because, like, that's where they believe the second key was. It was there, but it wasn't very obvious. There was different things, though. There was zombies, axes, and then there was one funny part where H found a naked lady. Yeah. And then, we didn't know what gender H was, but then we found out it was a girl. Yeah, so, I don't know. And it was just totally different. So they found the Jade King in Zombie Circle. Yeah, so Helen is H, so she is a girl, but she has a boy avatar. There was Taito, who was Taiso in real life, and then Sho, who's Zoe, who was actually an 11-year-old kid. Weird. So, and then there was this magic orb that... I can't remember his name, but only a magic spell could break it. It was a level 99 artifact. And then for the third key, they had to win a classic game. They were going through loads, and eventually they came to Adventure, which was the right one. But then someone got to the end, won, but then ended up dying. But then the problem was they had to retrace the steps to a dark room. There was this part where Chucky got sent out by H. Bad language in some parts. I thought there wasn't going to be any, but there was a little bit. Yes, like I said, someone won Adventure but died. Winning was not the right way. Now, there was this catalyst or something that this bad guy set off, and it ended up killing everyone around. But then Parzival survived, and we're like, well, how? But basically, I think someone must have given him an extra life. Can't remember who at this moment in time. And then, like, it was in the van at the time, so he was shaking around, so it was hard for him to win the game and then get the key at the end. And just practicing my Mario Kart was one of the good lines. And then when he ended up getting the key and all, he had to sign a paper at the end, but he realised it was a test, and then he went to James's room saw him as a kid and all, and there was this button that would shut down the Oasis completely. There were some amazing graphics in some parts, other parts not really. And then they created this organisation called High Five, and they took over the Oasis. They banned any loyalty centres, closed the Oasis on Tuesdays and Thursdays. There was a range of avatars, you know, from different games and all. And there was a catchy song that, yeah, I can't remember the name, but if you watch it, you'll know what song I'm talking about. Steven Spielberg directed it, so I thought, yes, this is going to be a good film. But I just thought it wasn't... I didn't get all of it, you know. But I know some people would. Simon Pegg was the only person I knew. The other people didn't really know. Unless... I mean, TJ Miller, I didn't even see in it. But then when I was looking at the cast and all, I didn't know, didn't even see him in the film. And then, yes, there was a kissing scene at the end, so... But, all in all, it was not a good film. I mean, even though I'm talking about some good stuff here, it wasn't fully good. So, I would give it a 3 out of 5. It's in the middle, but it's just not the best film. Plus, it has had some bad reviews on different sites, so that's why I'm giving it a 3 out of 5. But anyway... Hope you enjoyed this video. Of course it had spoilers, you know, I didn't mention that at the start, but I have mentioned that in the title, spoiler alert, you know, but I guess it's a bit late now, of course. But anyway, I might do another video tonight or tomorrow, not sure yet, but thank you very much for watching this video. Hope you enjoyed it, and I will see you in the next one.